Are you ready for Professor Lample Life Lesson 2? All right, today we talk about habits. Now, we're not having classes right now because of the situation with the virus. There is an opportunity there. No time for depression, no time for sadness. Opportunity. Here's the opportunity. You've got more time than you've had in a very, very, very long time. And it's time to put in new sets of habits. So let's talk about habits. First, let's talk about it's super, super important that you want to start using this thing here, the brain. Use the brain as a tool. The brain is a tool. We want to use it. Now, this is what the brain does. It does two things. It recognizes patterns and it creates patterns. The brain recognizes patterns. When you look at it into the world, everything is a pattern. Every social structure, what people are thinking, all music is patterns, all art is patterns, all science is patterns. The brain is constantly looking at the world, looking for patterns. The second thing it does is creating patterns. And now this is the very, very important thing. There's two kinds of patterns that the brain creates. Voluntary patterns and involuntary patterns. So this is the key to the things that you want in your life is moving from involuntary patterns to voluntary patterns, because even if you're unconscious, there are involuntary patterns. For example, digestion, things, eating, going to the bathroom, sleeping, those are all scheduled. And those are all patterns that are involuntary. Now it starts to overlap with the voluntary. What exactly do you eat? Now, if you're not consciously thinking about it, you're gonna go on automatic pilot, and whatever you've had for the past couple days is what you will have. Now, this is the really important thing, is that every kind of pattern you have, which is when you go to sleep, when you get up, how you brush your teeth, what sort of things you eat, how much time you spend with your friends, how much time you spend practicing music, all of that is habitual patterns that are now involuntary, because this is how the brain works. You need to instill things that are voluntary, and then they become involuntary and automatic. So it takes 2 weeks to create new habits, and they're hard for the first 2 weeks, whether that habit is getting up and exercising, where the habit is putting your five hours a day into practicing, all a habit. And it's hard for the first 2 weeks. So now the key of living, the key of success, is creating the habits that you want that sustains the kind of life that you want. And they have to be conscious. And this is really, really, really important, because what it is that you do every single day habitually is what creates your future. Now you may think, and it has been marketed to you, that your dreams create your future. Not true. Not true. This is what's important. Your habits create your future. Now, your dreams can create your habits, and then your habits then create what it is in your future. Your habits determine your future, not your dreams, your habits. So it's really, really important this particular week in your life that you create from this very moment on, create new sets of habits for yourself. Sit down and think about how much you need to exercise. What should you really be eating? And most important, even more important than what you're eating and exercising, is how much time you are practicing, how much time you are spending on music. There is nothing. That is the food of the soul before we get to physical food. That is what we live for, is music. Now you've got to get into better practice habits, meaning you need to schedule 2 practice sessions per day. Now, if you're moving from, you're only practicing an hour or two a day, to maybe increasing that for another hour, put in another block of time at another time during the day. Because your brain can only handle about 3 hours of practice at a time, 2 or 3 hours at a time. It's very, very important to do an hour or two chunk, take a break, do something else, put in another habit. That could be studying, that could be exercising, then come back and do your next practice schedule. Now, in creating those habits, and creating your schedule and these new patterns, because these new patterns are the condition for whatever kind of future you have. And this is the truth. I hate to say it, but you heard it first from Professor Lample. When your patterns are unconscious, you have a random life. You have an unconscious life. It's just like, you know, saying that you want to be a farmer. Great. What do you want to grow? I want to grow corn. Awesome. And then just randomly throwing whatever seeds wherever, and you feel like watering, you feel like plowing and fertilizing, maybe. No. You've got to be meticulous about it. And the things that you want for yourself in the future, the kind of musical career that you want, the sort of other kinds of relationships, all those sort of things need. They take time, and you've got to plant the right seeds, and you need to nurture those seeds over time. And that's what gives you a harvest. It's a one-to-one correlation that when you practice certain amount of hours every day, you get better exponentially. That's a rule of the universe. And that, with this, like gravity, that is the gravity of productivity. And it's no different than if you plant seeds and you water them, what happens? You get vegetables. Now you want to approach your own practicing that way. So from this very moment on, I want you to think about all the things that you have to do, and then put them in a schedule and do them daily. There is nothing more important than doing it daily. Nothing, 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 nothing. Because all practicing is training the neurology of the brain. So we've got the habits, that we want to get into the habits, which train the brain, and we want to get to the specific actions of whatever it is that you're practicing. If you're playing the violin, the, you know, scales and arpeggios. If you're playing the piano, scales and arpeggios, repertoire. If you're a composer, it's studying scores, and it's composing time. All that needs to be put in if you want to reap the rewards in the future. As you sow, so shall you reap, as it says in the good book, my students. All right? So now, in terms of the schedule, oftentimes people resist the schedule. Why? Because they say, Professor Lample, that doesn't sound very fun, and I can't do all the fun things that I want to do. And I say, whoa, hold on. Don't be an idiot. Schedule stuff to reward yourself and schedule fun time in too. Duh. So if that reward time is, you know, at the end of the day, what I do, I love movies. For those of you who know me, I love, 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 love movies. And so I work and I practice, and I'm practicing piano every day, which I'm very excited about. And I'm doing my classes and composing. Every day at 11 o'clock, I stop everything I do, because that's about 14 hours of work in a day, which is not bad by American and overachieving Jew standards. Not bad, 14 hours, not bad. And then I reward myself in an hour every day from 11 to 12 is where I watch movie. And that's what I do. I work all day, 11, stop, watch my movie, half of it. The next day I watch the other half of the movie, and that's what I do. And that's what I do to reward myself. And you should do the same, whatever it is that you like to do. Is it playing video games, going online? But don't do that thing until you have done all of your practicing. Use the things that you want to do as rewards for yourself at the end of the day, not at the beginning of the day. And of course, the same if you need to go out on the weekend, Friday night, very good. Stop all your practicing at 6. Make sure you're in bed early. The same Saturday, practice all day. Maybe from 8 o'clock to 11 o'clock, you go out, then you're back in bed. But keep that schedule every day. So in summary, Professor Lample life lesson, number one, use the brain as a tool. The brain does two things. It perceives and recognizes patterns, and the second thing it does is create patterns. Those patterns can be voluntary patterns or involuntary patterns. And the key to having the kind of life you want is to create voluntary patterns, which is practicing, exercising, whatever else that you want in your life, and then they will be start becoming involuntary, because the brain wants patterns to repeat every day. So once you take the 2 weeks, it takes 2 weeks to instill a good habit. So once you take your 2 weeks, get your good habits going, the brain will want that. Now this is the fascinating thing, because when you start the habits, at first, the first 2 weeks are really hard, but once you start them, after 2 weeks, your brain is going to want to do those things involuntary. It's the most amazing thing, okay? So create new sets of habits, good ones, that will produce the things that you want in the long term. And that is all for Professor Lample life lesson number 2. I'll see you guys next week. Bye.